What's up, YouTube? It's your boy Sax, and I finally took a break out of my busy homecoming week to make a video about the NX reveal, or now the Nintendo Switch. I gotta get used to saying that name. Thursday, Nintendo revealed what codename NX is, which apparently is the Switch. And while there's probably been a million videos of people basically talking about what it is to you guys already, I just want to shoot, you know, my shot at the opinions thing. If you want to watch a whole analysis of the trailer, there's probably someone else who can do it for you. That's not going to be me today. So first, let's talk about what I think is a good. There we go. First, I think the name and the marketing for the system with the reveal was spot on and like already loads ahead of the Wii. With the name itself, the Switch can be like gimmicked and put so many different ways and so many double entendres that will be catchy for consumers, you know, switch from your Xbox to the Switch, switch from on the go to your living room, you know, corny shit like that is what people like, and I can see that going so many ways. With the Wii U, there is no like real double entendre. They like try to do some whole philosophical thing with it, and it didn't really work. But this can be simple and gimmicky. Also, the video was not concise, but it basically showed the great things about the console. One, basically showed how you can take out the Joy-Cons, all the different controller options, which they showed four or five, and I think one of them was pretty bad, like the sideways Joy-Con with just one of those little things. I have small stubby fingers, that's not gonna work. It's not gonna work at all. But anyway, they showed like different controller options, how you can just sit the dock down, sit the system down, or how you can put it in a dock and enjoy it on your TV, and supposedly seamless gameplay, you know. All that stuff showed great. Like, you can enjoy it on a plane, at a party, on a basketball court for some reason, but you know, it showed like basically how the system could work. Also, like I said, it showed a lot of controller options. The Joy-Con concept is pretty interesting because you can slide off the Joy-Cons, so it makes me think, if you will, they create other Joy-Con accessories and have something like you know, what is it called? It was on the old 3DS. I have it somewhere. The little thing that you put on the back to give a, you know, another analog. I can't remember what it's called, but it was on the 3DS. I could just think of different types of accessories you can put to enhance different types of gaming experiences. I think there's a picture that I saw on Reddit that kind of explains the idea. I'll try to put it in the video and source it as well. Also, I think this is great because it also brings the unified Nintendo ecosystem that I talked about with my friend Henry, even though he hates this idea and he didn't want this to be the fruition. Finally, we've seen how with the Wii U had like mad gaming droughts, but the 3DS itself had a steady flow of games throughout the Wii U's life cycle and its own. With the Switch, I think all that should be unified into one, so we'll see a steady stream of games throughout the whole console life cycle. We should never have any missing games, and that's good for people who like me. I like Nintendo handhelds, but I can never bring myself to buy one because they're just so... I would never really take it with me. I have a 3DS and I can count. I don't actually pay my 3DS outside the house that often. Unless I know I'm going on a long trip, but I don't play my 3DS. At least not as much. And with this, it's like it gives you a chance to have both types of gaming experiences. So now let's go ahead and talk about the bad. Along with that unified ecosystem, I also kind of just see it being another Wii U where there's no third party support. And I know we saw Bethesda showing Skyrim and 2K showing 2K. I think it's 2K. I don't know who develops 2K. I'm not into the 2K thing. And they've already said that those games aren't confirmed. And while this really doesn't bother me, because that's why I got a Wii U, I have a gaming PC on my side. I know it does a lot of people who only want to own one console. And I don't think that's what this Switch is trying to do. Just like with what I mentioned in another video, Nintendo needs to find this niche in the market. I think this is what the Switch is trying to be. You're just supposed to have a secondary console in the house. You know, you can have your PlayStation 4, you can have your PC for gaming, you can have your Xbox One, but you also have your Switch for when you want a different experience. It's kind of like how the Wii was a different experience than your PS3 and your 360. And I think this is where the Switch is going. Also, even though we know it's developed by NVIDIA and it's supposed to have a really scalable and easy to develop for a chip with the Tegra processor, power is going to be a big thing. No matter how much we want to say something, how much we say we don't want to care. The Tegra K1 processor is not anywhere near as strong as the Xbox One. And while it's not as weak as the Wii U, we're still going to find ourselves as being the third place console again in this console war, especially when we send beefed up Scorpios and PS4 Pros in the world. And although, like I said, the Tegra is supposed to be a scalable processor and that should help with third parties, and I think I'll just keep my third party experiences on my PC unless they're exclusive. But yeah, like I was saying, I think the most interesting about this Switch is that it may be that niche. Interesting, I see that a lot of non-gamer friends of mine on Facebook were talking about this Switch and they absolutely liked the idea. A lot of them said it was innovative. These are people that aren't traditional gamers. And a lot of them talked about copying it. I'm gonna try to find these posts. The people who are mainly upset about the Switch are people who want Nintendo to compete directly, which is not a possibility at this point. Xbox and Microsoft and Sony are too strong. Nintendo needs to find a way to sit next to them and not try to fight. It's like bring a knife into a gunfight, and Nintendo doesn't have it. In a world where you have trophies and achievements and Steam this and Steam that and PlayStation Network IDs and free games, why would you want to switch to a different system? You wouldn't. So instead, why don't you try to make something where you have this and that? That's just my opinion. The other thing is about Nintendo's idea of not having optical media. Personally, I don't care about it. We're in a like streaming era, so at this point, if you're not streaming your music, streaming your videos, you're probably doing it wrong. Very few people keep CDs unless they're like Blu-ray graphics whores, and I'm not following the hype behind the Blu-ray thing. But yeah, optical media is not a big deal. I have an optical drive in my PC, and it's literally not plugged up. It's just sitting there. It looks cool. It looks real trendy and retro. So yeah, I don't think that should bother most people that it doesn't have support for optical media. But you know, I guess, you know, anything to call a shot against other consoles, because I don't even think that's a selling point for the Xbox One S. No one cares. But yeah, this video is longer than I expected, so I'm going to cut it off now. There'll be more videos in the future. Your boy Sax is out, chucking the twos.